Hello students, good morning. Today we are going to learn lesson 9 from supplementary and the title of the lesson is A Tiger in a House. As the title is shown here, A Tiger in a House, that means the story is related to a wild animal. And if we talk about the wild animals, definitely some people are very fond of wild animal and they love to keep them with them, and also they try to take care of them. In the story, the narrator, who is fond of hunting, actually he is one of the good hunter, and when they went somewhere in the forest and they found a tiger cub. Let us see what happens in the story. One day, the narrator's grandfather was walking down forest path, and his party was at a distance. He found a little tiger and brought him home. Grandfather was the only successful member of the hunting party. The narrator's grandmother named the tiger cub Timothy. Now what happened, that the author and his team, they went to the forest for hunting, and when his partners were in a distance, he found a tiger cub and he wanted to bring it home, and he brought also, and so it was very cute, and that is why grandfather was the only successful person who was a good member of that particular team, and he wanted to take this type of thing at home. And when narrator's mother saw that the tiger cub is very cute, and she also fond of it, and she named it like Timothy. She had given this cub name Timothy. Then she brought him up on bottle milk. Later he was put on a diet of raw mutton and cod liver oil. Afterwards he was put on the diet of pigeon and rabbit also. Now all the responsibilities goes to grandmother. Now if whatever story is taking place in the family, in the house, the narrator is noticing everything. So grandfather, he brought this cub to the house, and now grandmother, who was very fond of this cub, she brought it up on bottle milk because the cub was very small and they did not give him something else rather than milk only. Later he was put on a diet of raw mutton. Now when the cub grew up, it was given certain type of diet like mutton and cod liver oil, so and so. And afterwards he was put on the diet of pigeon and rabbits also. That means later on, when cub had grown up, it was given as a prey. What was that? Rabbits and pigeons. Then now what happens, there were some other animals surrounding area, and they used to play together with the tiger cub. And one of them is Toto. Toto is the name of a monkey who is very naughty in the story, and it always teases the tiger cub. What happens? Let us see. Toto the monkey pulled the cub's tail. Toto climbed up the curtain when Timothy lost his temper. Now what happens, you can see in the picture how the monkey is trying to tease Timothy, and you can see a dog is playing beside these two animals. And when the tiger, when it lost his temper, the monkey used to run away from there. He and a mangled puppy were Timothy's companions. You can see here. Now the monkey is there as well as puppy is there. Both were good friends of Timothy, and Timothy used to play with these two animals. But thing was that monkey used to tease him by pulling his tail, and puppy, it always tries to climb over the tiger. So that is why the tiger used to lose his temper, and that time these two animals, they used to run away from them. Then when the narrator came to live with her grandfather, he became one of the tiger's favorite. What happened when the narrator also came to the family, when he noticed that the tiger is there and it is very cute, it is very familiar with the grandfather as well as grandmother. So narrator also was trying to be friendly with the tiger, and finally at last he became good friend of tiger. Initially Timothy was afraid of the puppy. What happened? The tiger, who was afraid of puppy. Puppy here is a dog. But finally the puppy was allowed to crawl and rest on his back. You can see here, before tiger was afraid of puppy, but later on when it had become good friend of him, he allowed puppy to sit on his back. You can see here in the picture, the tiger is happily allowing the puppy to climb over him. Then after some time he was of full size. After some time the tiger was growing on and he was on full size. Sometimes he pulled hard at his chain, some when he was chained there, and he was trying to break the chain because he had grown up now and it had become a big tiger. You can see in the picture how the narrator is being with him. They are both are playing, both are walking together, and they are trying to be good friend of each other. The narrator kept up with him with a great difficulty. Now what happened? The tiger had grown up and it was very difficult for the narrator to keep the tiger with him because it was very dangerous also. And he reclined on a long sofa in the drawing room. He snarled at the everybody and he had clean habits. Now what happened? Now tiger was trying to sit with him, he was trying to be with the narrator, and he used to sit on the sofa. Wherever he goes, tiger also follows him, and this was of course for him it was good, but for other people it was very dangerous. And now this had become difficulty for the narrator. How? Because it was very difficult to manage his diet also, and he was snarled at him. He was showing his anger to other people who used to come to visit the narrator. Then he slept in the cook's quarter. He preferred to be taken out in the morning for a walk. He grew less friendly when he became 6 months old. He also started eating small animals. Now the tiger had grown up, and definitely if it is grown up, its diet also grown up. So he was always trying to prey some other or small animals. That is why he grew less friendly with others. Why? Because they were stopping him to prey the other animals, but this was his habit. A tiger who is a meat eater, he has to prey the other animals, and he was practicing all this thing. That is why he had become less friendly with others when he was at the age of 6 months old. He also started eating small animals. Whenever he gets certain type of small animals, he used to eat them. Why? Because the tiger is very fond of animals. A change came over him. Now his behavior is totally changing because he had grown up, and so far he was a wild animal. He became less friendly, in fact more dangerous. Then the grandfather took him to Lucknow to gift him to a zoo. What happened now? Day by day he was growing, and as he was growing, he was becoming very dangerous. So far he was very friendly with the narrator, but for other people he had become a danger, and that is why other people, they also said to the narrator that you should not keep this type of dangerous animal at your home, you should gift it somewhere or you should send it to the zoo. Then in Lucknow, the grandfather presented him to the zoo. Now finally the narrator decided to gift it to a zoo, and for that he had taken this tiger to the Lucknow, and where he presented this tiger to the zoo. After 6 months, the grandfather went to see Timothy. He stroked the tiger's forehead, tickled his ears and smacked him across the mouth. The tiger licked grandfather's hand. What happened? Now he had presented tiger to the zoo, and after that 6 months passed, and after 6 months grandfather, he decided to visit that zoo again, and he wanted to meet Timothy. He wanted to see how he is living or what type of behavior he is having. And when he went there, he stroked his hair forehead, he tickled his ears as he was trying to show his love towards Timothy. And the tiger was also very happy to see his master, and the tiger licked grandfather's hand. The tiger was also trying to show his love towards grandfather by licking his hands. Then it sprang away only when a leopard in the next cage sneered at him. Many people watched the scene. A keeper of zoo called the tiger bad temper. He had no knowledge about the owner of the tiger. What happened when narrator went there? Narrator and his father went there. Definitely they noticed that the leopard who was just next to the tiger, it was always sneering at the tiger, and because of that the tiger's temper was increasing day by day. And the keeper of that zoo, actually he was not knowing why the tiger is always in the angry mood because of that leopard. So he had no knowledge about the owner of the tiger. Now the keeper who was taking care of the tiger, he was not knowing that the grandfather was the real owner of that tiger. Then grandfather wished the tiger to be transferred to some other cage. A leopard in the next cage would constantly rush at Timothy. However, he could not meet the superintendent. What happened when narrator is noticing that the leopard was trying to tease tiger? So he requested to the keeper that you should shift this tiger to another cage, and for that he wanted to meet superintendent of that zoo, but it was not possible to meet him. The grandfather returned to the tiger's cage. Now grandfather, he went to the tiger and he was trying to talk to the tiger that yes, I was the one who had made you comfortable, and today you are here. So to say goodbye, he stroked and slept the tiger. Another keeper observed him with alarm. He also recognized the grandfather. He informed the grandfather about Timothy's death of this and that. Now what happened? When the grandfather was meeting tiger, he was showing his love towards the tiger, and but the new keeper, he was not knowing. When the old keeper, he had come there, he recognized the grandfather who had gifted him this tiger. He tried to come to him and he said the whole story about his Timothy. He said that the tiger whom you are meeting is not your tiger, it is some other tiger whom we brought from somewhere, and your tiger, he has already died. He also informed the grandfather that he The dangerous tiger was trapped only last month. The tiger whom he is meeting, they have brought it in the last month from somewhere, and it is very dangerous. The tiger was still licking grandfather's arm. Now you can see here, the tiger is still licking grandfather's arm, and tiger was trying to show his love, though the grandfather was not his master. But his love towards the animals, he changed his behavior. The tiger was still licking grandfather's arm. He was smelling fresh food. Grandfather somehow withdrew his hand from the cage. He gave the keeper a scornful look and bade the tiger good night. Now what happened? The tiger who was there, he was cool and calm in front of tigers and all these things. The grandfather, who was not knowing that the tiger whom he is meeting is not his own, he has already died. And at the end of the story, the tiger also changed his behavior towards other keeper also. And so far, grandfather, who showed him that you are not like that, but you are made like that by someone else. Before to leave that zoo, grandfather went to the tiger and he scrolled here and he tried to show his love, and at last he said good night. And this type of thing was there. And the tiger, who was very familiar with the grandfather, he also came to know that towards love he should also change his behavior. And at the end of the story, when grandfather, he came to know that his Timothy was already died before 6 months, and the tiger whom he was meeting, it was not his own tiger, but the tiger was behaving in such a manner that grandfather understood that he was his own Timothy, but he was not his Timothy. So this was the story of the lesson. I hope you understood the story. Thank you.